Testing 1 2, testing 1 2. All right, testing 1 2, testing 1 2. Mute that before it comes back around. Okay, switch to public, and I think we ought to be live now. Let's find out. Maybe. Hello? Anybody there? Hey, hello, Galtar Dude 1138. All right, I see this is actually working now. Perfect. Still says about like 14 concurrent viewers. Hopefully the announcements or however they work went out. But now it looks like people are in. So I think I got to mention in the first like 30 seconds or so, and hopefully this is still in that time frame. This is sponsored by Paradox Interactive, which is super exciting. I actually like went out of my way to like to find them and be like, hey, there's a game coming up. I want to, like, whatever you're doing for your, you know, launch, like, I want to be involved. So this is super exciting for me. Someone whose name I probably shouldn't say aloud on stream just got the announcement. Muhammad Haikal saying, restore Rome. Yes, for the glory of Rome. Abba saying, CK3 already came out. Yes, so CK3 comes out today. There is... there's a link in the description, which will hopefully work this time. I don't know why it didn't in the community tab, but there's a link in the description that, will take you to their site, and it has, like, my special URL so that they know that I sent you. And so that way I can hopefully continue to, like, do stuff with them in the future. It would be awesome. So... Herbert says, is this your first time playing the game? No, I actually, I played... for a little bit last night, so you can see I've got a an auto save ready. Basically, I just went in to get myself like familiar with the systems and like the way that the UI in this game works as compared to CK2, which I've played before, and it's a little different, so it took me a little bit to get used to, but I think it's like ultimately a lot cleaner, and it shows the information in a way that is a lot like easier to read, because there were systems in here that I like never paid attention to in Crusader Kings 2, like the supply limit as you're going through, you know, marching into places with your army. So now all of a sudden I'm like, oh wait, I can only put so many troops in one place. That's why I can't just buckle all my troops together and send in just one massive army. Suddenly everything makes sense. But yeah, that is about the extent of how much I've played this game. WYKD sends in a donation. Thank you so much. Saying, love you, Jack. Basil is one of my favorite Byzantine emperors. I'm guessing you mean the second? The famous one? Orange Monkey says the link works. Excellent. The link is working. So with that, I can probably jump into... the game and not have to worry about stuff too much. Asmo says go to war with China. They don't have China in the base game, but they have all the way to like India, which is kind of insane. They also have all of these sort of like, you know, starting characters that they've recommended, like instead of just doing Duke whomever of Leon, you know, they can now be like, oh, okay, so if you want to start in, like, England or Denmark, if you want to go all the way back to 867, or if you want to, you know, start later than that, I'm not sure where exactly, but I think you can start it, like, pretty much any year. I want to watch someone do a playthrough of, I think this is, Lotharingia, which historically was just completely, like, wiped out almost immediately by East Francia and West Francia, and I want someone to somehow pull that off and manage to win with that. I'm switching the difficulty to very easy because I am not a pro gamer. So let's see, we'll go to 1066. Basically, the objective here is we're gonna play as, I forget the name, Basilius, I think, the Byzantine general, or Byzantine emperor, in 1066, and he was from the Doukas dynasty, which was, on the whole, sort of disastrous, if I remember correctly, and basically, in actual history, in 1071, the Byzantines got into a fight with the Seljuks, and they had this huge pitched battle at Manzikert, and they lost horribly. And so that was 1071, and like by the end of the decade, they had lost just all of Anatolia. So if we can go in here and become Byzantine emperor and not lose all of Anatolia, I will consider this a victory. Or not lose all of Anatolia by 1071 to 1080-ish. Yes, Basileus Constantius X. Difficulties at war. Okay, so I believe this is all the same. Yep. Gluttonous, lustful, and arbitrary. What a wonderful guy. So we can just jump into here. Oh, yeah, and they can... Can I even show the whole map? Anyway, I can once I get into the game. So, we have started in 1066. Yeah, the map, like, by default, even though, like, when you think, you know, the Crusades and Crusader Kings, you tend to think of, like, this area. But there's also all of Scandinavia and Central Asia and all the way up to the Liao Khanate, the entire Indian subcontinent, basically all of Africa north of the equator, although there's lots of this, like, you know, impassable desert where there's just not much of anything. So I did do the same scenario when I was playing before, and I discovered quite quickly that the challenge of playing as the Byzantines is that you really have no natural allies to help you. I tried to get the Fatimids to, you know, maybe, like, they could help me against the Seljuks. Presumably they must have had some beef, but they are a different religion than I am, and so they all hate me. And then I tried with, like, you know, the Holy Roman Empire. I tried, you know, maybe there's a way to, like, reconcile with the Pope somehow and call on that crusade a little bit early. What I ended up settling on was Georgia here. So basically the Seljuks are, if I zoom in, they have an enormous army that I can never hope to compete with, just ravaging through Armenia. And my strategy, as I'm sure someone in the comments will tell me why it's terrible, but my strategy has been to quickly ally myself with Georgia, even though he doesn't like me. He's apparently quite open to an alliance on account of, I guess, just, you know, base willingness already being into it. I don't know. Hooks. So this is something different compared to Crusader Kings 2. So basically, you have the ability to, like, if someone... I think the example that came up with me was, like, one of my vassals, you know, offered to tutor me in the ways of deception, and so I was working with him for a while, and then at the end of that, you know, I got what I wanted out of it. But then this random vassal has a hook that he can use on me, and so suddenly he starts asking, like, hey, I actually don't want to send my army to go fight the Seljuks anymore. And I had to be like, well, I guess I have to accept that because I owe you a favor now. But in any case, so we can set this guy to negotiate alliance. And so the strategy is to almost entirely ignore Armenia. And probably just because I have it set to very easy difficulty, you can, as long as I am able to invade their territory and hold more land faster than they are able to go through my territory, then there is a way, in theory, to kind of pull this around. So let me set up, go to military tab. There's some other cool stuff in here that I'll get to in a second. Like the men-at-arms system is really cool in this game. Let's see. Okay, so we have rally points. I think what I can do, if I'm not mistaken, is I can add a rally point over on my eastern side of the empire. I can remove the one in Constantinople, and hopefully that will save me a little bit of time in terms of transport, just trying to get across the Hellespont and all the way over the empire. The nice thing, though, the other nice thing about this game is for anyone who's played Crusader Kings 2, the way you would have to travel across water was kind of finicky, where, like, you would have to, you know, raise your fleets, and they would show up at all different points of the empire, and you'd have to, like, move them all to one point to ferry your army, and then you'd have to take it across in multiple trips. And now, sort of automatically, like, if by sea is the fastest route, like, I think originally I got my guys in Constantinople and wanted to bring them over to Chaldea over here, they'd kind of just automatically go over by sea, and it handles the costs of that behind the scenes, so to speak. Taking a quick look at chat. Boom. Empire saved. Automatically. Cheat with dice. Hurry, your demo is expiring. My demo is expiring? Where does it say my demo is expiring? Because I did get this on the beta, so maybe it will expire. Who knows? I think I've got it for a while. Anyway, so the other thing to square away before we get started. Oh, first let's raise all armies, and hopefully they'll all show up over here. Yeah, so it'll take 26 days to get them all ready. The other thing to get started with is so there's, in addition to sort of just, you know, ruling your empire and being like, I think what sets this apart from a lot of other strategy games is it's not purely military, even though this is most of what we're going to be doing is military. But you have, for instance, so in addition to all of like your vassals conspiring against you and having to, you know, keep an eye on your relationships with all of them and what factions are popping up and those sorts of things and who's on your council and who you're making angry, you're also sort of, you know, inhabiting each of these characters who all have their own different personalities and traits and things. So the way this system works is it has a little bit of like RPG elements to it, where you can select a lifestyle. And so because we're going to be doing so much warfare, I'm just going to jump into martial, even though you get an extra bonus if, like, you if you follow whatever your character's childhood was like. But we're going to go martial. And I love speaking with this much authority as though I actually have a competent strategy. Then, yeah, so each of these has, like, three different routes. So what we're going for is, you know, you can also get, like, more authority, which helps you, you know, rule your territory a little bit more tightly, because, like, Byzantium, I think, or the Byzantine Empire is, at this point, pretty loosely controlled. They had the I don't know how to pronounce it, the Tema system, the theme system, where they pretty much, like, broke up all their provinces and said, all right, you guys, like, you each get your own army, you each do what you want, you just need to be, like, ready to go when the next incursion happens. So we're gonna go with a strategy focus, which will give us some extra martial experience, which will allow us to level up a little faster. For some reason, this goes from the top down rather than from the bottom up. So the first thing that we get is this just makes it easier for us to. Oh, am I not able to unlock this yet? I thought I was. Anyway, the first thing is just to, like, makes it easier to declare more wars. But eventually you start getting stuff like this, which has significant advantages to, like, all of your units. So we close out of that, and we should eventually get some more units there. The other thing we want to do before we start our attack is go look at the men-at-arms. So this is basically, you can get special units, and the advantage we have as the Byzantines actually corresponds with the Empire's strategy in real life, which is that even though they don't control a whole lot of land and are not, like, a military superpower, they're pretty rich. We have a pretty good source of income right now, so we are able to, you know, sort of buy some more units for now. And you can see up here at the top, the cataphracts, which are not what we want to go for. I'm afraid if I click on it, I'm going to select it, even though I don't think that's actually the case. Yeah, it'll show you more about what they're useful for. So this is, I think, like different kingdoms and different empires each get their own sort of like special units. So I think like if you're, you know, England, I think you get like longbows. You get like a camel brigade if you're Egypt. So because we're the Byzantines, we get cataphracts. And it actually, another upgrade from Crusader Kings 2 is that it'll show us a little bit more easily, like in advance, this is what these guys are good for. This is what they're weak against. So we are, actually, I guess we are going to be in a lot of these places. But I am looking for, I'm not sure the difference between these two. Oh, are these even better? And what is the point of these? Small torsion catapults can tear down enemy fortifications. Traction power magnol is easier to operate than the onager while also being a faster rate of fire. So it sounds like it's just better in every way. Maybe this is another special Byzantine something. But since our strategy is going to involve like sieging them faster than they can siege us and hoping their army doesn't turn around, we are going to create a regiment here, and we're actually going to upgrade it right away. Full maintenance is only 0.3 a month, so we can do that pretty easily and get it all the way up to like size 3. So that should help us lay our sieges a little faster and go on a good old-fashioned crusade, European Productions TV. Just looking at other people. Sees you saying I should have played in Ireland. Ireland is the, Ireland is like Tutorial Island, but it is, I don't know, to me, I'm having a little more, like, I can get the bonuses of Tutorial Island just by switching it to very easy, and get to do all the, like, the cool role-playing elements of, like, aha, I am in charge of the Byzantine Empire. I am really curious to see if we do manage to win against the Seljuks, how that's going to affect the Crusades, because the Crusades sort of started because Alexios Komnenos, asked the Pope for some help. So, A, we have to worry about, because we're the Dukas dynasty, we have to worry about the Komnenos family, I think, leading a revolt against us. But after that, we might be able to do without the Crusades, which could hopefully avoid the Fourth Crusade, which would be put us in a really nice spot, but I don't think we're going to get there today. So let's progress a little bit until our army actually starts to coalesce into one place. Aha! To the chattering Basilius Constantinus. You know what? That's better than what he called me last time. Last time, maybe I have a differently, like, randomly generated reputation or something. But last time, every single time I would talk to this guy, he would be like, ah, yes, hello, the vile, despicable, evil Basilius Constantinos. I would be honored to help you. I want to be your best friend. This time, we're only a chatterbox. Cool. So, this means that Georgia will get involved in the war. Let's see how much longer we have to wait for these guys. 21 more days. Okay, so we have a little bit to wait. The other cool thing is that it will show you, I believe, their full forces. So if we click on this, yeah, it'll give us a nice, easy visualization of who's at war with whom. And I don't think the war would have actually started the second the game began, but it allows us to see their total strength here. Yeah, so we have a total force of, ooh, I thought we had a little more than that. Maybe we need some mercenaries. But yeah, we've got 7,000 compared to 28,000. So we're going to do our best and hope for the best. Because that is the thing with this game is that, I guess I should leave this running. Not all kingdoms are created equally. And by choosing an empire that was historically defeated at this exact moment, we've really put ourselves in a precarious situation, as already our towns are under siege. But hopefully by having Georgia help us... Oh, you know what? I actually forgot to invite them to our war. There we go. Lovely. So hopefully what we can do is use Georgia basically as a distraction and have them defend Armenia while we go raid basically the whole eastern coast area here and hopefully plunge into, like, you know, Baghdad and whichever river this is, Euphrates. Oh, yeah, here we go, to the loathsome Vasilius Constantinos. That's such a great way to write to your friends. So what I should do with this army is probably I should split it up, first thing. And then you kind of have to zoom in before you can see geography. And I believe I'm having someone in the chat can probably help me with this. The ones... So in Crusader Kings 2, these were all these cities and things were sort of like you had to click into the territory and look at it to get that details. Now they're on the map. For some reason, I only seem to be able to lay siege to the Temeriots and not like any of the mosques or other places and not even all of the Temeriots. So I'm not totally sure what constitutes as a place you are allowed to lay siege to. Hopefully someone can help me with that. Need to split this up. 3.5. So we want some place that can support more than 3,500. Because the nice thing is, if you find... Yeah, so like that's a mosque. I don't think I can actually... Why are you not splitting up? Okay, there we go. So that's just one of them. So I think this will get them separated. Maybe, maybe. And then I'll check chat so I can actually... Nope. Where are you going? Okay, they are going to different places. Cool. So I'm going to check chat real quick and see if anyone can help me here. Emperor Justinian in the chat saying, I think it's a hierarchy of what you can siege, kind of like in CK2 where you had to siege the top holding and then the sub holdings. Oh, that could be. Like, I have to take the, like, you know, take the kingdom first, then the principality, then the county, then the barony or something like that. Nikolia Vukovic says, maybe it's like an imperator where if you siege the fort, everything around gets occupied automatically. I did have one instance where... Oh, boy. I think there was one instance where, like, I laid siege to a city, and then the neighboring city was also captured. So I think that could have been, like, a capital thing. Muximal Mod says, Jack, worry about the Bulgarians. Take their land a bit. You know... You raise an excellent point. I probably should beware of the Bulgarians. But for whatever reason, I'm not going to. Because I think the only way that I can win the war against the Seljuks is to really, like, throw myself at them. And, you know, potentially that leads to the Bulgarians invading. But if I can get the Seljuks to at least accept, like, a white peace... and basically accept the status quo antebellum, then that would allow me to double back on the Bulgarians. Whereas if I surrender to the Seljuks, then that would mean they... I think they... Right now, I think they're laying claim to just sort of all of, like, Armenia. Let me go check that. Yeah, so if I click surrender, it'll show me they're going to get all of these different... Aha, yeah, they're going to get all of these different... principalities and counties, so I want to try to avoid that as much as I can, and just hope that the Bulgars show mercy. Zoom in here so we can see geography. And I did originally, like, if you can get these guys separated, there's a chance you can win a battle, but there's so many of them so close together that I'm afraid what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk in there with one army and be like, aha, yes, the 1600 group, I can take them out. And then the entire army is just going to, like, dogpile on me. So we are just going to try to trade cities here a bit. Oh, yeah, so this is, like, I can't seem to lay siege here. So let me look at the kingdom titles, duchy titles. Yeah, so maybe I need to attack here, because that seems to be the capital of this duchy. And if nothing else, I should be able to at least attack that one, surely. Where are our special siege boys? Oh, I need to raise them separately. Okay. Well, I'm sure we can handle a couple sieges on our own. But yeah, this goes a lot faster once you get the special siege boys involved. Let's see. Yeah, so we've lost some territory already. That's fine. Greetings, my charming liege. I know you are a dedicated servant of the Lord. I therefore hope you will look in sympathy on the fact that our duty to you weighs down on our ability to do God's work. So either we need to pay up, which we can't really do, or we put our manpower elsewhere, or because I think we... This is the patriarch, right? He seems to have a positive opinion of us, so I don't know why, but I believe that, like, our emperor is not recognized by him. It would be nice to have him on our side, but I think ultimately I'm just going to disappoint him and hope that he doesn't try to kill me right away. It should be fine, because he'll only have a moderately low opinion. Okay, so this group is ready. Let's throw them over here. It's also interesting because there's sometimes, while playing this game, sometimes I recognize the locations from history, and then sometimes I'll know the locations from the game, and then see them come up in history and go, oh, wait a second. I actually know where that place is. Here's 11,000 more Seljuks. Come on. Nice. Okay. So, I think because they have all their armies clustered up together, just by virtue of having ours split up, that should allow us to start to push this war score in our favor. And I promise I will not do the thing I did the last time I played Crusader Kings on this channel, where I had 100% win score and just completely ignored it and been like, huh, I wonder why the war isn't ending. Someone is suggesting just to surrender and save the army, but like save the army for what? Because I believe, like, I have a feeling, I guess historically the Seljuks ended up collapsing not too long after, and I could wait them out, but this is probably better content. I'm just trying to avoid any sort of, like, large-scale Manzikert-esque battle. Because, you see, what my real objective here is, all I really have to do is make some interesting footage for 2 hours and get myself into trouble and try to sell copies of the game. Ho-ho. I don't actually have to make this thing survive until 1453 or whatever. Okay, so let's send... Actually, let's put everyone over here so we can divide the siege engines evenly between those two armies so that we don't just have one useless one. Then we'll have to split them up again. Ah, we have a child. Excellent. This is, I don't know who... Oops, he's gone. There was an annoying thing about, like, I tried to make an alliance with someone else earlier, and it said, like, you have too many alliances. And one of the alliances was, like, to my wife, who owns, like, a single county, which was terribly frustrating. I didn't realize there was such a thing as too many alliances. I thought I could just be friends with everyone. But alas, such is not the way of the world. And apparently Georgia is just copying our strategy and not working as our decoy, as we had hoped. Let's see. Ooh, we get a Ducas Dynasty Legacy. All members of the dynasty benefit. Can spend renown to unlock legacies. So, I mean, I still think warfare is going to be what we're going to need long-term, because that is the Byzantines' weak spot that ultimately... cost them everything. It would be so nice to get glory and just focus entirely on the glory of Rome, but I think more practical matters are going to get in the way here. So it benefits our personal combat and it makes our knights more effective. Well, that's not exactly the most useful thing. Casus Belli cost, that's not super useful. Martial life. Okay, that would be more useful. That would be pretty useful. Popular opinion. Actually, some of these other things might be handy. Scheming and popular opinion, because no one seems to really like us. We don't have any main allies, and it would be nice if we could... not have to worry about A, our vassals trying to destroy us from within while we're in the middle of a war, and B, not have to worry about having hostile nations on all sides. So I am kind of liking the look of that. Dread is another interesting thing, which is basically like, if you can't rule with love, just rule with fear. But I think I'll actually go with a little boost in popular opinion. See what glory would have gotten me now that I've completely ignored it. Marriage acceptance. Oh, okay. I mean, that's useful. Just having as many children as you can so you can marry them all over the place. Maronian saying, check the mercenaries for the Varangians. Oh, that would be helpful. Try to make friends with some of the Bulgars or Croatia. Yeah. Let's see. The trouble is, I'm not sure. Like, so my go-to is usually like, aha, I need... Oh, Croatia is really not happy. Maybe... I'm guessing these are the Bulgars. So my default is usually to be like, aha, let's arrange a marriage. I'm not sure if they will accept any, though. Knights, knights, knights. So if I marry off this random courtier... Yeah. Yeah, so just on account of having, like, a different faith, they have a minus 1,000 to, like, any marriages. And I don't think I have anyone who is, whatever faith they are. Wherever that is. Aha, but their military strength is inferior to ours. So I don't know, like, how else are you meant to, like, start making allies? You can never defend Bulgars. The Bulgars are going to start fighting Cumania very soon. Oh, that would be helpful. Cizio, I'm loving your suggestions. but that's the thing. Everybody loves a good underdog story. So we must restore the glory of our... How do we have no income? Oh my god, I thought we really had more than that. Thank god we're still on the positive. So we wait for this siege to end. and we give them a little bit of time to recharge. Because the nice thing is if you leave your soldiers in territory that can support them, even if it's just occupied enemy territory, you have the benefit of, like, eventually your soldiers just start to replenish. And maybe this is actually, like, a measure of how effective they are, and that's, like, morale or whatever plus the number. But either way, it means that basically you can just go all the way into enemy territory and support yourself. Let's see. We can use a hook on our heir. In line to inherit titles. What titles am I in line to inherit? Interesting. Ah, yes, I can declare 14 wars. That's what I need. Who are these people? Oh, are these all, like... Some of them are Khans. Ruthenia. Syracuse. Yeah, I don't feel like getting involved in any of that. So this is somewhat simpler if I just completely ignore the rest of the world and, you know, just focus on one thing. Focus just on fighting the Seljuks for now. Oh, yes. Okay, so I did conquer this place, and that got the other territories as well. So whoever suggested looking at the duchy titles, very helpful. Although I don't have the total control of the duchy yet. Anyway, now that we've got these two split up, we want a place that can support at least 3.4. Here's a couple 3,500s. These aren't enough. That's a mosque. Cool. Well, we kind of want to be heading further in anyway. No. There we go. If the AI were smarter, they would probably wait until I got into, like, here and then just, you know, pin me in with 28,000 soldiers all at once, but I don't think they're that smart. Though there is a multiplayer to this game, which would be very interesting. I don't think... Oh, now they're just standing there. Why can't I siege? Let's try this one. Hope for the best. It doesn't really matter where we capture as long as we capture it. I'm sure there's places like, you know, if you take their capital or whatever, that's obviously a bigger hit. I think because they say they have like 28,000, I think this actually numbers to about like over 20,000. So there's a chance that like we could just go straight into the capital and no one would stop us. But I am not ready to risk that. Because this is all we have, and if we lose it, then we all we have done is completely replicate the historical failings of 300. I can supply up to 300? That's incredible. I thought it was just 100. So I can't attack here. Let's just keep moving. And if we can make it to 1071 without an enormous crippling defeat, then we're in good condition. We're still making money. We've still got all of our resources here on the positive. Uh-oh. Where are these guys going? I really hope they haven't become smarter than the last time I played this. Otherwise, we're going to have some issues. Especially while both of my armies are bogged down in separate sieges. I have sort of relied pretty heavily on the AI not doing anything to stop me. This could be a major blunder. Although no one actually seems to be... Oh, no, you know what I think they're doing? My guess is that they are hanging out in their own territory as a means of supplying themselves. Which is what I've done on occasion. Because I don't see any arrows indicating that they're moving further, which they would definitely have done by now. Sieges are almost there. See, I tab out to... Well, I'd have to pause to tab out, and then that would sort of defeat the purpose. Empty council position. Oh, dear. Oh, that's the other thing we can do, is So I need to put up a new spy master, so I can just look at who's the best at intrigue. My half brother and vassal. I don't know if I want to put a half brother in a serious position of power. That sounds like that's asking for murder. This guy's just about as good. He's a knight. He's a seducer. An intricate web weaver. Sadistic, deceitful. Oh man. He's got an interesting personal life. Is time still moving? No, it's not. So we have a new spy master. And so what we can do is as we so what we can do something like what Muximul Mod has suggested, and we can try to influence some people to befriend us and hopefully try to get a war on multiple fronts for the Seljuks, which would be pretty cool. I don't know how effective that's going to be. We would need to try to find like an Indian ally probably who is kind of neutral about us and see then if they can attack the Seljuks from the east. Or we can try to take care of some matters at home. War Thunderers is suggesting getting rid of Alexios the Fourth. So that could be, a potential way to just keep things chill. Or we could just go for a total long shot and just try to assassinate the leader of the Seljuks and hope that it works. Because if he discovers us plotting, what's the worst that's gonna happen? We're already at war. Just become the Ottomans. Kidnap the Seljuk Sultan. Can you intentionally like plot to kidnap? Let me see. John N said, my exact reasoning for not getting CK3 Imperador was such a crash and burn. I don't want to see a repeat. I have not followed Imperador. So far, I've been enjoying CK3 quite a lot. It's like it doesn't deviate a ton from CK2, but it really just sort of like refines everything, and it makes it a lot. I guess if you're already familiar with the games, then you kind of know your way around CK2. But certainly from someone who doesn't have a ton of hours in the game, like getting into this game was a lot faster than getting into CK2. And it's a lot easier to like see all the information that I need. What was I just about to do? Someone had suggested something, and I thought, oh wow, that's a great idea. Become the Seljuk's vassal. Oh man, that would be interesting. Seduce the Sultan. If you isolate the army with the king and capture him, you will automatically win the war. So, okay. I thought about that. I'm having a really difficult time seeing which army actually has the king. I don't know if there is an easy way to do that. Because it will, oops. It should show me with the armies in this location. I should be able to like see each of them and see who's in charge. But the trouble is going to be, okay, yeah, Commander. No, I need to remember what the guy's name is, but I don't think he's any of these. Emperor Sultan Al-Muzan Alp-Arslan. Okay, so we're looking for Muzan Alp-Arslan. Because all these armies have different commanders. I am having trouble trying to actually get these to look individually. This one has a different commander. Okay, I gotta double click on it. Yeah. So they don't seem to be. Ah! Oh, wait. Okay, so he's over here. That's relatively isolated. The problem is still like, I guess if we worked our way all the way around and got to him, then that could work. But the fact that he's got, another Like, these are all approximately 2,000, so call them, like, 5,000 altogether, plus another 5,600, easily outnumbers us, and I think it's a lot slower, and we're at risk of the Bulgars attacking, but I think if we just kind of, like, work our way through the different territories, I think that's going to be the, like, steadier, more methodical approach to this. I don't know why this group can be supplied up to 300 and the other one only up to 100, but I'm not really questioning it. So these guys are still well supplied. Let's throw them into... I guess it's helpful to do... to continue working over here. We didn't assign our spy master. So... Alexios the Fourth. God, I don't know where he is. I see, this is where my historical knowledge is failing me. So these are all my children and siblings. Because I don't remember who Alexios the Fourth. Like, I don't remember what region he controlled. So I have no idea how to find him. There might be, like, a search bar somewhere. I'm just going to continue on oblivious and just do what I set out to do. Who are... Okay, so the Ghaznavids could be a potential ally. But the problem is they hate us because we are arbitrary gluttonous... extra gluttonous, and orthodoxy is evil. So it would really take quite a lot to be friends with them. And I feel like it would be... I feel like it would be almost more effective, although it would take a lot longer, is if we got, like, a European ally. Because I feel like we have a better, starting point. Like, I am a lot... Of course, he hates us because orthodoxy... No, he hates us because... We're club-footed. Maybe Hungary? I think if we get a friend over on our west border, then that can help us against the Bulgars, potentially. Minus 35. It honestly looks like these guys are our best bet, honestly. So what we can do is attempt to sway them. I can offer to be his guardian. Let's not do a lavish gift. Let's just try to sway him. If scheme is successful, it will increase opinion by 25, which isn't quite enough to make him think positively of us, but we can always continue to scheme again. So let's work on that. And hopefully that will sort of pacify our western borders while we focus on fighting the Seljuks. These guys are... Oh, no, they're losing supplies. Okay. Oh, I see. They're just over the limit. So... I think 3,500 is about the max of any of these places. We can send them down here. Yeah. And that will still allow us to do a hasty retreat if we have to. Still sort of watching this group up here. Just to see what happens to them. Aha! Praise Saint Brigid. Yes, that saint I am definitely familiar with. He's given birth to a perfect little son. Who will you become, my child, and what shall I call you? This is kind of cool. Do these have, like, different effects or something? You can name him after me, after my father, after Eudokia's father, after an ancestor. Interesting. Let's just go with a good... Yes, let's name him Constantine. The world needs more Constantines in the Byzantine Empire. Awesome. Game's rolling again. Well, at least Georgia seemed to get the idea of what we were doing and help us out with these sieges. Oh, this is the other interesting thing that I remember seeing, is that there's like all these other random armies that are hostile to us but also seem to be fighting each other within the Seljuks, so I don't know if that's like their vassals just having a go at it or what that is, but suppose I could look. So if I look at the commander, the Alephan conquest of... Yeah, okay, so he is... He's fighting someone else within the Seljuks, I believe. Even though if he's from Aleppo, we currently occupy Aleppo, but whatever. Oh, no, we are fighting him. Okay. I mean, I assume we're going to win this battle, but it's just going to take us a while to recover, but that's okay. The battle was still... Yeah, so we're still at +7, even though we just lost the siege, because we won that battle. Oh, apparently that didn't really affect our war score at all. Whatever. So I think I'm just going to let these guys sit for a bit. Oh, no, they're still well supplied. All right, I guess we just keep moving. See, I love the idea of the glory of just running hell-bent into the middle. Seljuk, oh, someone's saying Seljuk armies are moving. You have 19% war score, peace out. Oh, wait. Are they moving towards me? If they are moving towards me, perhaps it's time to make that retreat. Because I don't know if I can make a white piece yet. Yeah. I still need... Their base reluctance is 30, so I still need another, like, 6 points. Ooh, they are all moving. Georgia seems to be... Oh my god, I think Georgia just saved me because they're all moving back north. Let's see how this plays out. Yeah. They're all attacking Georgia. Oh no. Well, this probably isn't going to be great for our relationship with them. But, oh, this is interesting. Because if... I don't know if I'm... daring enough to try this, but if we were to like come around, how long would it take us to get there? Because if we got all the way up here, it would take us 2 months. I think they'd be gone by then. If we happen to be up there now, then like Georgia fighting them while they're currently in a siege, and we could potentially capture the Sultan. I mean, that would be amazing, but I don't think it's going to happen. I mean, we can always try save scumming. and just, you know, see how long it takes and then go in after. We'll just have that as a little backup. I am neither particularly talented nor honorable. But I think this is far from the game for having honor. This has also been really cool because I've been... Oh yeah, George is getting crushed. I should pay attention to the date. This has been really interesting because I have been like so much into Byzantine research lately, to a astonishing degree, because between the useful charts video that, you know, gave me kind of the rundown of the whole empire, which I could not, you know, retell it all to you at this point, but it gives me enough that I can jump into it at random points. And then the video that's coming out this Saturday is I've given some hints to my Patreon supporters that have all been like, you know, Constantinople, sort of what time period it's around. Who are these people fighting in my empire? says they're neutral. So between, like, between the Useful Tarts video, the video I'm working on for my own channel, starting to play this, and then the video after this next one is probably also going to be related to, not the Byzantines exactly, but still, like, within the realm that talking about the Eastern Empire is a legitimate thing. How well stocked are these guys? Still at 100 of 100. Let's keep moving. That's the one with the Sultan. Yeah. I mean, they're in the back, so, like, potentially, like, if we, I guess they would see us coming because we're in their territory, but if we could, like, loop around and capture the Sultan, because what I would really like to go for is, like, just a complete victory, enforce our demands, because that would remove all of the Seljuk's claims on our territory and would totally set us up for not having to worry about them for a little while, and hopefully just waiting them out until they collapse in on themselves, and at which point maybe we can focus on the Bulgarians. We'll see. I guess let's get a little bit closer. Let's start laying siege to some of these places, which could potentially put us in harm's way, but also make it a little easier to... Did they just combine armies? No, okay, so he's still in that one with 1,800. These guys look like they're moving west. So I definitely want... I think I'll keep... Instead of going to where I know he's going to start, like, siege immediately, let's go here. Oh, I see. All right. And then we'll reinforce with this army once they get there. They're neutral. Oh, okay. So now they've all grouped up. Yeah. Now we'd have to face... I mean, we could still win against 5,000. But they're also coming in with that. So that would be a real decisive battle. I mean, we can see how well stocked they are. Maybe. If they're poorly equipped, then we might stand a chance. Oh yeah, they're undersupplied, going on starving, and still moving deeper into our territory. So there is an option. Maybe I have to click on the number. But they're well supplied. So the army with the Sultan is still pretty well supplied. Oh, but the Georgians are over here. I'm still going to keep an eye out on them. We might still be able to try it. I know whatever I do, there's going to be people screaming at me in the comments. For anyone who just joined, we are playing as the Byzantine Empire. We're made it to 1068 so far. We're trying to get to... first to 1071 without losing a decisive battle. And then trying to get to 1080 without losing all of Anatolia. So far, we seem to be on the right track. They're still in pretty good shape. Let's see if I can let them recover their numbers a little bit. We are almost at a point where if we need to, we can... Yeah. So we can end this war right now if we need to. But that still leaves them open to... I guess that would put us in a truce for a little bit, but that leaves them open to attack us later. It looks like, yeah, that group is going off to fight the Georgians. There's like 12,000 of them, but some of them are pretty... I thought some of them were pretty undersupplied. Maybe I was wrong. I still can't figure out how to actually get a look at the different armies. I thought I was clicking on the number, but apparently not. I still have, like, Manzikert looming over my head. Stop to read. Okay, I see people saying rush the capital. CSU still says stop fighting. Other people saying kill the heathens. I mean, I'm in this all the way. Like, I'm not ready to declare peace yet. Osmo says, I was here 30 minutes ago. You said you'll defeat the Seljuks, but they took their lands. Yeah, basically, they're taking our lands, but we're trying to take their lands more. Says you'll only get to 75% without fighting. Is that so? Is there like a max that you can get from occupying other lands? I am amazed at how many people are just shouting peace, peace, peace. And then one guy who's like, just take the capital, just go all the way, just do it. Everyone's saying peace. Ah, this is so... But I so just want to march all the way in. How much is it possible to get to 100%? Yeah, occupying counties. Oh, occupying counties has a cap of 100%, but I'm already at 80%. So I would need to get more. Basically, I need to take back some of the counties, some of my counties that are currently occupied. So that would give me, if I took back all the other counties, that would give me 53%, which would still get me up to like 76. So then I would still need to win some battles in order to get to 100. You're right. I don't think I can actually get to 100. The only shot to get like to 100, I think, would be to try to like capture the Sultan. Even with, like, say these guys take out these guys, that still puts us up against 10,000 of them. So I think you're right. I think peace might actually be the best option. So this does... Okay. So we can offer peace. We'll get prestige. Wait, we lose prestige and then gain more? I don't totally understand how that works. So we can offer that, and then we'll end up with peace. And then, so what we sort of need to be doing in the meantime is trying to... I guess we can take it in a number of different directions. So the Bulgarians have just... This Khanate has just split up into a bunch of different places. That could potentially be good for us if we can, like... ally with them and, like, split this up somehow and take some territory there, but I don't think overextending our territory is really the best option. Somehow we need to, like, create a larger army that can actually stand up to the Seljuks in the future. I don't 100% know the best way to do that. To the chattering Basilius Constantinos, may you be sewn up alive in the belly of a dead camel. I accept your offer of peace. Let us put this conflict behind us. Cool. Okay, so we get more prestige now. Our war has ended. We can start raking in some more cash when we start putting our armies away. Is there... Yes. So I just want to make sure that all is still good. Cool. We can disband army. I love that they just magically... Oops. Are these guys not disbanded? That they just magically, like, instantly return home. No marching required. So, okay. From here, I mean, we have managed to get the upper hand in a war against the Seljuks, which is pretty good, all things considered, considering the actual Byzantine Empire did not fare so well. What we're left with is a situation where I really wish I knew more about the history. Like, I wish I knew if the Seljuks would, like, just tear themselves apart the way the Bulgarians seem to be doing or not. I guess, okay. So what is the best way to increase the, like, maximum size of our army? Obviously, you know, we can get a bunch of money for mercenaries. I think what we end up having to do, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, is we need to end up increasing crown authority, which will allow us to increase taxes as well as levies, and that should give us a bit of an advantage. We have our succession laws, our vassals. Okay, yeah, this is where I'm going to chat to get some things. Pechenegs, not Bulgarians. Oh, are they not Bulgarians? I just sort of assumed that it was like a different term for the Bulgarians, because I just sort of assumed the Bulgarians were like always there. My apologies. Need friends in the West. Hungary can't be trusted. Microraptor asks, is history in this game as insane as it seems to be in your videos? So, yes. It is. I mean, by default, everything in this game is laid out kind of as it is in history. So that's why, for example, you know, the Byzantine Empire has the borders that it does. That's why when we started the game, we were already in a war with the Seljuks. But in some ways, it actually gets, like, particularly insane, because you get to take the reins, and so you can, you know, do stuff like, ah, yes, I'm going to assassinate my ally and marry his widow, and in CK3, I don't think you could do this in Crusader Kings 2, but in Crusader Kings 3, you can create your own religion. And you can pretty much give it whatever policies you want. So if you want to, even though it probably won't be very beneficial, you can be like, ah, yes. So what we're going to do is, we're all going to be cannibals now. We're all going to be polygamous cannibals, and that is the word of God. Oh, hello. Greetings, Obi-Wan Kenobi. However the General Grievous quote goes. So, okay, I'm seeing, you can't let Bulgaria have that broken up Bulgaria. Take the broken Bulgarian kingdom for yourself right now. That is probably a good idea. It's a shame, because the Pechenegs were the most friendly towards us. And Croatia and Hungary both seem to hate us. There's a chance we might be able to get on Hungary's good side, because I think they're currently involved in, like, a civil war or something. So if we were to support the right side on that, that could potentially give us a pretty powerful ally over here. It does seem like the quickest thing would be just to gobble up some of these, because considering how many, like, territories in the Seljuks we were able to occupy, like, occupying just two or three of these could give them to us for a long time before we allow any sort of major power to show up here. I think that might be the move, because as long as then, like, if we can use those extra territories to increase our levies, that gives us a better chance at standing up against the Seljuks in the future. How long do we have a truce with them? Until 1073. Okay, so that doesn't give us a whole lot of time. Let's see. This will probably tell us, yeah, who we can declare war on. I don't want to declare war on the Pechenegs. Although there's a chance we could take them. It depends if they have allies. But the ones I'm looking for are sort of these smaller states. Yeah, okay, there's Buzau, Chikoviste, Gyurju. I don't know how to pronounce any of these, I apologize. So, I also know there's a certain, like, threat level. I don't think ours is going to be very high, but it's just something to keep in mind, because I don't know if declaring multiple wars on smaller kingdoms will end up, you know, giving us a greater overall threat level and just decrease everyone's opinion of us. Let's see. So, yeah, all right, let's try going for... Oh, we can do a holy war for the kingdom, for the duchy, for the county. I mean, I think it's all more or less the same, but I assume we want to go with the kingdom. Your level of devotion is less than Paragon of Virtue. Do I need to be a Paragon of Virtue to declare war for this? Oh my god. What? I see. I thought as the Byzantine Empire, I would just have, like, you know, de jure claims to, like, all of Europe. But I guess that's not the case. I have two allies now? Oh, right. Yes, of course. My wife, who is also my vassal. Any Orthodox rulers of vassalized by you... You may only attempt one holy war against a kingdom tier title per lifetime. So if this is all one county. Again though, I still don't have. I also don't understand why it costs devotion, like why it would make me less devoted to my faith to declare a holy war. What is the best way around this? Because I assume it's going to be the same with anyone I try to attack, right? A coat of arms is just swastikas upon swastikas. So if I said declare war... I'm running into the same problems. You know, I can claim like a single county maybe, but that's still going to cost me more... faith than I have, and it's going to take me a long time to build that up. It's not a swastika. I realize it's not, but it looks like. Convert to Catholicism. I mean, I could. That would honestly win me a lot of allies. I don't even know how many Eastern Orthodox people I'd be losing. Like, the Russian Empire isn't a thing yet. Fabricate the claim. Oh, duh. Fabricate the claim. Oh, you try to cross the Danube. Develop your holdings. Is this the Danube? Am I up against the Danube? Oh, there's too many decisions in this game. Let's say first, let's boost our crown authority. That's going to make all of our vassals unhappy. But... I think we can afford that. Our vassal opinion is still positive on the whole, so we would lose our plus 10 from this. But that's okay. Levies are 413. Pass limit. Provide at least 5% of levies and 2% of income. Yeah, I think this is going to be the best way to strengthen ourselves. So now, facile opinion is still positive. We should hopefully get more levies. Cool. So as long as we can afford that, let's see what our spy master's up to, because that will affect our claims. I think he's still trying to make the Pechenegs like us more. Which is still in progress. And I don't think they're in a position now where they can really do a whole lot. So let's cancel this scheme. Let's abandon it. Let's begin a new scheme. Oh, we can have a hostile scheme and a personal scheme going at the same time. That's nice. Maybe I didn't have to cancel that. It's all right. I think I want to win over Hungary or Croatia or something. Maybe Hungary. So we go to our spy master. Let us... I would like to get a foothold over the Danube. Does it say where the fjords are? Not exactly. Well, one's right in here. So if I... No, hold on, that's not on him. I need to do that on the realm, the county. I've totally forgotten how to fabricate a scheme. I forget if I need to do it from the... from here? Or if I need to do it from my, from my council menu. Why am I having so much trouble with this? I don't totally understand. Someone's going to be screaming at me. Let's see. Nope. All right. Priest on council to fabricate. Okay, so it is through there. Council. Oh, wait. Priest. What? Why would it not be the spymaster? This is giving me more trouble than it should, because I've done this before. Help. Help, chat. Catholic Byzantium will further ensure the Empire's survival. It probably will. Ah, Fabian Dolce says, finally I'm able to catch one of your streams. Welcome. You've joined at just the right time while I'm trying to figure out how to create a scheme. Oh, it's one of these. Got it. Okay, got it. Fabricate claim. That's right. So, if I say, I can only do that on a county level? Well, this is the head of this. So I guess let's do that. Although, if I'm only able to take a single county, I feel like that will just give these people more reasons to attack me. Like, I want to be able to take... Oh, I guess this whole thing is a county. Yeah, okay. Because if I'm only able to take, like, a small portion of it, then it might not be worth it. Unpressed claim. Monthly progress. Yeah. It's not even the most valuable of places, but it's just a matter of trying to boost my armies. If I go over here, I believe it would be over here. Where do I go to look at my religion? Because it might be time to be losing my religion. See, this is why I just led with like attacking the Seljuks, because that's something I can do that's a lot more visual. Council Realm Military. Maybe it's a personal thing. Like I just need to convert myself. But there's got to be like a thing that says, you know, in your empire, in your domain, here is succession law, crown authority. Think it would be in here. Personal, educate child, arrange marriage. Am I not able to change religion? Bet you there's something I need to do. Fervor. I see. Size of faith is not super small. Religion at bottom left. Okay, got it. Thank you. Gnosticism. Yes, we'll convert to be Gnostics. we'll make Byzantine a Cathar state. Take Croatian lands. They're splitting too. Make friends with the HRE with Catholicism. That's what I'm thinking, because the HRE would be a pretty nice ally to have. Marry a Catholic or educate your heir with a Catholic guardian. Oh, that's right, I can do that. Oh, okay, so here's where I. Okay, well, that just takes me to Orthodoxy. I can create a new Christian faith. This is where. Okay, so this is where you can, like, affect the tenets of your, whatever faith it is that you have. Holy sites. Ah, okay. So I believe so someone was actually talking about like taking Jerusalem, and if I apparently if I actually did take Jerusalem, that would give me a nice faith bonus. Let me view other faiths. Because if I were to switch to Catholicism, oh, okay, so I can click convert to faith. Watch everyone in my empire immediately hate me. Oh, this must be where Serbia's splitting apart. Yeah, so like there's all this, but there are so many different things. This is gonna be a disaster, I feel like. Convert to Catholicism. Oh, 16 of my 34 vassals will convert? That's not bad. Let's go. Total cost. Oh, I need. So I need to be a more devoted Eastern Orthodox Christian before I can convert to Catholicism. Okay. But we can do that if. So if we take Jerusalem, which is currently controlled by the Fatimids. So if all we do is we press a claim on Jerusalem, go to war with the Fatimids before the Seljuks can attack us, then we start getting a lot more faith, then we can convert and hopefully make allies with the Holy Roman Empire. Meanwhile, all of this area slowly starts tearing itself apart, and hopefully the Seljuks start tearing themselves apart. So we go back to the council. We say, hey, stop fabricating on whatever else that was you were doing. Fabricate a claim on Jerusalem. Probably be handy to have Jaffa as well. We'll complete in 3 years. Oh, that's gonna be like most of our time. But there isn't really any reason. Yeah, that's shorter. But I think Jerusalem is going to be a lot more useful to us. Why are these different colors? It says this is also the Fatima's Ultimate? Luckily we're not facing Saladin or anything, so. Count Nikephoros of Demetrias has accused Eudokia Komnenos, a noblewoman, of having an affair with my spy master. I do not see what the fuss is about. It's not as if lust is an unnatural affliction. So two people gain. So either one person loses opinion of us and we imprison them, or everyone thinks we're a cool person. Turns out being lustful has its advantages. Ah, lost level of devotion. Oh no. Well, you know, I'm sure it's fine. Oh my God. We're working on it. We're working on it. We're gonna get Jerusalem. Can we just de- I don't think we can just declare war for just Jerusalem, can we? Because Jerusalem's really all I want. If I make it a holy war, I feel like there's a risk the Seljuks might get involved. Oh, I need to pause the game. Within the target title, all hell. So, if I were to try to say, this is all Jerusalem. I think that's the city of Jerusalem. I don't know. Or does it need to be on my borders? Oh no, I just don't have enough piety. I don't have enough piety to get more piety. Gosh darn it. Well, I guess we're gonna have to wait for that that fabricated claim on Jerusalem to come in handy. And then eventually, then we can get Jerusalem and become pious and convert to Catholicism because of how pious we are. And for right now, we just sort of pass the time and hope no one's trying to kill us. Actually, let's do. Let's keep the rest of our council busy. Levy size, garrison size, and reinforcement rate goes up. Or we can have men-at-arms maintenance goes down. Or we can increase control in county. Let us organize our levies. Yes. Let's do that. Okay, he's working on that. We want to. Domestic affairs or foreign affairs? I mean, if we end up converting, we probably want domestic affairs in advance. This is interesting because they're not. It sounds like they're not going to particular provinces, which is how it worked in Crusader Kings 2. Yeah, let's go domestic affairs, because I'm sort of counting on Catholicism to boost us internationally. We have our steward. And the only possible side effect is extra taxes, and not like she gets caught. Increased development. Ooh. I think I still want to go with increased taxes. And let's see, religious relations. Okay, that'll give us more piety every month, which we could really use. Convert faith in county. We don't really want stronger orthodoxy right now. Okay, he's already fabricating the claim. That's right. So we'll be assigned to disrupt schemes, support schemes. I guess let's have him supporting our schemes. I'm potentially too confident in not having that many hostile schemes against us from our allies, but we'll see. Go on a pilgrimage for piety. Thank you. I'm not seeing the chat the whole time, so that's why I haven't been listening. Catholic Byzantine Empire, absolute heresy. Well, look, sometimes we got to be pragmatic about this. Okay, so it says go on a pilgrimage to promote... Okay, how do I go on a pilgrimage? I love it. I love that I get to learn the game at the same time. I'm guessing it's either in my faith menu or I have to go to my character. But this only gives me... Yeah, this only gives me the same things about... arranging marriages and educating children. So, about that pilgrimage, ladies and gentlemen. Decision tab, decision screen. Take Georgia to secure your area of the Black Sea, but Georgia's my only ally. The intrigue screen on the right. Okay. Why would it be on the intrigue screen? What? Oh my god, there's so many different things coming at me at once. I'm still gonna go with trying to boost boost my faith so that I can convert. I don't think I wanna get involved with the Fatimids yet, because even if I take some of their land, I mean, I guess I might be friendly with some of them, but then I don't think any decisions. Aha. Ah. Go on a pilgrimage, undertake a pilgrimage to prove your dedication to God. Okay. That makes sense. Take that, everybody. It will be unavailable for 15 years. Prepare for the journey, I guess. Wait, what? Well, that sounds like a really short pilgrimage. Do they all... Hold on. Oh, I can't close out of this. If they all boost my faith the same amount, I mean, it would be really nice if I could just stop by Constantinople, because I also don't seem to have the gold for these other ones anyway. Cool. So I just spent 150 gold trying to, be a little more holy. Okay. Oh, I guess it's not available for 15 years after I do it. So we depart on our very long pilgrimage, from the palace to the Hagia Sophia, which is literally right next door. The perks of being Byzantine. And then I guess we'll see how long it takes. Apparently it is taking days. He's really going to all of... Bandits! Oh, dear. Let's see. I don't want to... Okay, so there's a chance I get wounded. Okay, so this is really my best option. 44% of gaining... more prestige, or... Oh, but I would have to spend 75. That still doesn't guarantee it. I think that's acceptable. I'm not really planning on spending it on anything else. And it would really suck to suddenly die. I'm just imagining, what? Occupied. Oh, I guess my dukes are fighting each other. I'm just imagining, walking straight out of the palace and just spending days going to the Hagia Sophia and getting robbed along the way. Automatically be rejected. Oh, what's this ransom? Pays 25 gold of Homs. I don't know where that is. I'm not really planning on doing anything else with him, so I'll take the extra money. Aha! Okay, I finally stand on the hills outside Constantinople. I have left Constantinople so that I might arrive at Constantinople, a glimmering jewel of civilization that echoes with the glory of the Roman Empire. It is truly a sight to behold. Near the center, I can see the Hagia Sophia, the great center of worship, which is often considered the epitome of Byzantine architecture. It is far from the only wonder here, though, and I gaze over the city, I marvel at the glories of God's creation. Yes. Oh, look at that. Faith. Wow, that was so much easier than pressing a claim on Jerusalem. Thank you. Yeah, there are actually a lot of really cool... So I've also been, like, looking up at a bunch of images for the next video of, like, 5th century churches. And there aren't a whole lot that are still around, but, like, all, like, the Byzantine architecture from that time period, the ones that are still around are awesome. Like, there's the Hagia Sophia, but there's also, like, the Hagia Irene and, like, several other churches in the same place. Really cool stuff. So now that I am a pious man, I believe I can go into my decisions tab, and nope, that's not the right tab. I can go over to my religion tab, and then go to other faiths, and then go to Catholicism, and then convert to faith. Your old faith... Oh, now 19 of my 34 vassals will convert. Excellent. So that's still a majority. We're just going to have to deal with the rest of them. But my close family and vassals will convert. So the ones I need to watch out for, I believe, are all over here. I think Moesia is over here. Armeniac, I'm guessing, has something to do with Armenia. It's hard to see. I'm going to take it. Bunch of people are going to consider me astray and no longer love me, but that is something I'm willing to do, because now, hopefully, yeah, so they hated me at like minus 93. They hate me less now. Still not big fans. How about the Holy Roman Emperor? Does he like me? Not exactly, but like, we can get over that, I'm sure. So now would be the time to... I'm thinking... I want to see what's going on in Hungary and Croatia, because I think if I can get involved in the civil wars there rather than with the Fatimids, I think they'll end up being stronger allies in the long run. So I want to see... Let me see this war going on. Someone was saying Croatia was tearing itself apart. They're allied with each other. It doesn't say that the kings are at war with anyone, though. That's the issue. It'll probably show me up here. Because I think there's a war that I can just, like, jump into free of charge. Ooh, no thank you. So I don't want to declare war on all of Croatia. But there should be another, like, of Croatia. Unless they just haven't started yet. What is my casus belli against Croatia? Okay, I have a de jure duchy in there. Gotcha, okay. I mean, I feel like as the Byzantines, I should just have a de jure claim on the entire Mediterranean. That's just me. Oh yes, the patriarch, the new patriarch does not endorse me. I'm shocked. Absolutely shocked. Ah. She is excellent at battle, even though she will never battle. Oh well. Let's take a look at... There was a map that showed me, like, how well under my control everything is. Yeah. So this... Oh, okay. So we got a lot of... I mean, most of the vassals have converted, but there's still a lot of, orthodoxy nearby. I guess that is the thing to put the... the patriarch's probably still, still orthodox, isn't he? Yeah. Can I... I can't fire him. Catholicism does not have revocable clerical appointment, but he's not Catholic! You can always... There's always a court chaplain or realm priest. Cannot assign a new chancellor. Oh, no. This is my chancellor. Okay. Whatever. He's still Orthodox Greek. But if I want him to be able to... No, this is the guy that does... Yeah, converting faith. Well, I guess it would still be nice to have Jerusalem, maybe. I don't need to act on that claim immediately. And then as soon as I'm able to replace him... I wish I could see who my options are to replace him, because it might be worth it just to try to assassinate him. But, oh, no, he's Catholic. What? Okay. I guess if I've accomplished a convert... I think I should focus on converting counties then, I assume. I'm going to switch over and everyone's going to be shouting at me. Corey Studios, I have converted to Catholicism. They will convert after a couple of revolts. It's nothing big. Patriarch is now a cardinal. I don't know how that works. Yeah, let's send him into... I guess let's start with the areas kind of around Constantinople. We'll complete in 4 years, 4 years, 4 years. I'm never going to finish a task because I keep aborting and just giving up on what I was doing earlier. Meanwhile, we still want to be... I hope I haven't totally alienated myself from Georgia, but I think they're still my ally. I want to see Croatia and Hungary start fighting among themselves so that I can get involved there. Arrange marriage, request claim... I can just ask the Pope for stuff. That's nice. I can make random people my vassals. So can I just, like, go over... I'm sort of tempted just to be like, hello, sir, do you want to be my vassal? Oh, who's he at war with? Tuscany. Okay, I don't want to get involved in that. This is where I get... stumped, and I'm not sure what I want to do. More ransom. See, there's also these little Caucasus states that I could potentially get involved with, just the same as these. I can lawfully... Is that my wife? I can lawfully imprison her. Would it be beneficial for me to have Basilia Eudokia? No, this is Eudokia Komnenos. I suppose, would it be beneficial for me to have a Catholic wife? I assume it would be. Dukes Nikephoros, who is that? And what is my spymaster currently doing? Or whoever sways opinion. I think it would be my spymaster. Oh no, I guess I think I just have an open, yeah, I have an open thing. Sure. That sounds good. I feel like I ought to be scheming to kill someone just because that's what it's all about, but I don't know whom. More ransom. Guess that war paid off. I probably got some people that I could pay ransom for, but, you know. Oh, I was still on... Okay. It took me like a year just to travel around the city. I'm still... decent quality. I thought it was better than that. Click to show details for your levies. Monthly reinforcement. Still paying that for my siege engines, naturally. I'm trying to think of better ways to boost my army. Is that the guy that I'm scheming against, I guess? Having a lot to keep track of. Oh, so this must be... like different warring factions within the Fatimid Sultanate, right? Because if I can't get into defending against of the Yusufid Emirate, okay. It's if I can't get involved in anything in Croatia or Hungary, it might be beneficial for me to help out the Fatimids here. Yeah. So they... okay. What are my casus belli against him? Oh, it's all holy wars. Okay. So I can't just step in as a friend. Like, hello, hey, heard you were having trouble. Just thought I would like to introduce myself. I think the other thing is, I guess Constantinople isn't a holy site. Yeah. Yeah. So I do have the advantage of having, or the disadvantage of having fewer holy sites in my empire now. That's a shame. That's a shame. Ooh, a shady discussion. I am passing through the castle gardens for a morning walk when a soft breeze carries the voices of Dobroslav and Michael to my ear. The two courtiers are talking to each other in a secluded spot nearby, frequently glancing around to make sure no one is listening. While it is hard for me to make out most of their words from a distance, it is clear the discussion relates to Duchess Anush. Who is she? I must warn her. If only I could get... oh, I could spend... ooh, so 50%. He tortured them. I mean, I gained 20 dread, which I feel like is a good thing. It's in green. It must be a good thing. And there's a 60% chance I learned the conversation, where this is only 50. Let's just grab these two people. After several hours, they are ready to confess their secret. It was an unsavory habit. I see. Oh, she's a cannibal. Well... that's interesting. See, this is where this game ends up giving you all the crazy fun history stuff, similar to the videos. See, I feel like I just need a good war that I can just make things so much simpler. So they're fighting. Are they fighting over religion? No. Just want to make sure about that. I think let's I'm interested to get into, like, you know, one more war, and after that, probably call it a day. Okay, here is the populist uprising going on in Hungary. So this could be my chance to this could be my chance to get involved there. Oh, I guess I'm right-clicking on it when I should be left-clicking. So, can I declare war on this person? Offer to join... Oh, no. I guess I can't offer to join the Hungarians either? Because they're not my ally, technically? Oh, I can offer to join war. Offer to come to the... Okay. A defender of your faith... And the or to help a vassal put down a peasant revolt. Okay. That seems like it will be helpful just to get me on the right side of my Western neighbors here. He's also for the county of Rutgers. Okay, I'm not going to get involved in that. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to say, hello, friend. I am here to help you. I am coming to join your war. I would sway him, but I think I'm already swaying someone else. Let's join the war quickly before the Seljuks come back. Okay, I can't join the war because he's not my ally. Why did it give me the option here but not in the last one? I just want to be friends. How do I do this? If the Seljuks are already in a war, they won't defend the Fatimids. Reconquer Italy, take Jerusalem. We may or may not still be hatching a scheme on Jerusalem, unless I gave up on that one. No, he's converting faith. Yeah, we gave up on Jerusalem. I'm sort of interested just on, like, on getting my western border safe for now. The Fatimids, again, I don't think I can offer to join their war either. Yeah, this one just doesn't give me the option. I feel like if it gives me the option, it must be somehow possible. But it says he does not lead a... Wait, he does not lead a side? In the uprising? I assumed he did lead a side. So the defenders... Oh, the defenders are the Holy Roman Empire. All right. Well, that works out for us, too. Let's go help them out. So if we go over here, then we can say, hello, I'd like to join your war. And he's not our ally. Gosh darn it. Can I make him my ally? Will he accept a marriage between someone? Because if I'm going to get friends with anyone, I feel like it's going to be the Holy Roman Empire. Yeah, it's not like France thinks highly of me. But the problem is I need to have good enough rapport with him in order to make that marriage happen in the first place. I don't think I want to... I think she's in line to inherit some things, Princess Anna. So I want to offer someone else. No. What if I offer him a son? He has no one to marry. Well, shoot. I hate when this doesn't quite work out. I don't know if this will help me at all. I don't know if this will make him ally me, even if he did accept it. Doesn't like her, doesn't like me. Yeah. Yeah. Also, it's probably not the greatest to marry a random courtier. Okay, so right now, my guy is scheming to make one of my dukes like me more. How is that going? It's still going to take another 2 years. I guess let's run the clock and see if maybe we can... Because I don't want to just abandon everything. I think I'd rather just, you know, let some time pass and then try to get the Holy Roman Emperor to like me more after I don't need to worry about this guy scheming against me. In the meantime, nothing eventful seems to be happening. Which could be a good thing, could be a bad thing. Did I just see some territory move around over here? I still wish I could go and just jump in on the Fatimids. I don't suppose I can help the attackers. No. That would be fun. How are you supposed to, like, mess with people if you need to be friends with them first? You can't just, like, I want to be Byzantine Empire World Police. He's not a fan. Let some more time pass. Okay, let's make the goal here to be make friends with Hungary, and then we can call it a day. Aha! Okay, we've got another child. We gotta start marrying these children off. But no one wants them! Practically giving them away. Trying to send them out to random courts across the world, and no one will take them. Hitting a bunch of cash, though. My god. Could probably start just sending gifts to people. Bribery is always a fun way to make friends. How much would a gift to... I guess, how much would a gift to the Holy Roman Emperor cost? Pope, can you give me a claim on the Holy Roman Empire, please? Now that I've converted. That was the issue, right? Is that, like, oh, the Byzantines, they're Orthodox, and the Pope doesn't really like them, so he'll give it, you know, he'll make up the Holy Roman Empire. So now that we're Catholic, I feel like we should definitely have a claim to that. So we say, send gift. How much? 150. We can afford that. He'll accept it. It only boosts his opinion by 14, though. So I think we probably want to start with, like, a scheme or something that will get him up a little bit. Because how much do we need for him to accept a marriage? Oh, but he doesn't have... Yeah, he doesn't really have anyone that we can get a close marriage to. Hungary, I don't think, does. Yeah, no, these are all random courtiers. If we send him a son, he's got no one. Croatia. Okay, so there's a prince of Croatia. But he won't accept because... I have too many existing alliances, and he doesn't like me. But okay, so it's minus 33, so I need to boost that by 33. So a gift won't do it all the way. If I could get rid of my alliance to my wife, that could help. Because then I wouldn't have too many alliances anymore. Can I just end this alliance real quick? Considering she only controls the county of Lesbos. Almost suspicious of a wife coming from Lesbos. Request divorce requires 100 faith again. Base reluctance. The Pope doesn't like me, and the Pope really likes her a lot better. Why does the Pope like her so much, even though she's Eastern Orthodox and I am Catholic? This I do not understand. I feel like this is gonna be, I feel like this is a feedback loop. Like, as soon as you start getting some people to like you more, it becomes a lot easier to win over the others. But right now it seems like I would need to get the Pope to like me more so that I could then divorce my wife, so that I could then get the Holy Roman Emperor to like me more, so then I could get Hungary to like me more. But unfortunately, I don't have a foot in the door with anyone. How do I just ask for a crusade? How do I be like, hey, if you could just go and attack the Fatimids and the Seljuks for me, that would be awesome. Fatimids are still tearing each other apart. I guess I don't really have any reason to declare war on these. How's my intrigue going? Still another 12 months there. How is my council doing? Another 4 years left of converting faith. Yeah. Because I wouldn't mind having a claim on Jerusalem, but that would take another 4 years anyway. How are the factions against me? I should probably check those. Okay. Wants military independence. Okay, a couple places in the Balkans want independence. Oh, sweet, new perk. So this is where, yeah, casus belli cost can go down, or my dread and control goes up. This, ooh, so I went with this last time because I like all of these, and this is definitely better against like the Seljuks. But having just converted faiths, I think a little extra dread would be pretty good. Although casus belli, I am also looking for wars right now, so I've completely gone back against this. How did the Byzantine Empire fall? Well, suddenly they just became super aggressive and just attacked everyone nearby for no explicable reason. Reading comments again. Holy war on Rome, Charles V style. Kidnap the Pope and make him allow me to divorce my wife. That'd be brilliant. Crusade on Huguenots. Invade Georgia and then Jerusalem. I don't even know if I have like a casus belli against Georgia. Like, I don't even know if I can do that. Plus the fact that I'm allied with them probably would make all of my neighbors hate me even more. Declaring war will break the alliance. Oh, okay. I have a yeah, de jure county. I think I'm better off. I wish I could speed this up a little bit. I'm gonna keep rolling, try to get my what's his face priest back. Aha. Ancestor Catholic name, Greek name. After I gave. Yeah, no, let's go with this. Having more people with the same name is always a good idea. Trying to get a sense of like how ready they are to attack me as soon as this truce ends. Because what I would love to do is just to have the Seljuks and the Fatimids fight each other, or even better, get the Seljuks and the Ghaznavids to fight each other. I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. A noble guest has arrived with a claim on the Principality of Salerno. Okay, I guess we have Salerno's. It's around Italy, isn't it? Well. Oh no, that's all different stuff. I guess I can check. Who can I declare war on for Salerno? Holy Wars, I would need to. I wish it was showing me the casus belli on the side here as soon as I see them. These are all Holy Wars. All Holy Wars. Maybe that's how you do the Crusades, is you just have to declare a holy war and then try to get all your religiously affiliated allies to help you. Seljuks. Yeah. Don't see any reason to arrest her right now. Okay, so I can modify something with a hook here. So that will give him more feudal levies when I need it, and it won't count as tyranny. So I'll take that. That's a nice little bonus. We can shrink all these wars. I should really get in the habit of letting things play while I do this instead of pausing the whole time. Prisoners can be ransomed. This guy. It would be nice to have some favors. So, like, this guy, for instance, is. If I can see him. Yeah, over here. I'll try a favor on him and I'll just get the cash from the other person. Because he's also my prisoner anyway. Never know when you might need a small favor from the enemy. I am called to war against. Well, you know what? I was looking for a war, and I got one. So that's a county. Okay. On accept, I join the war, or I lose. Okay. So I'll accept. I don't know why. I don't know what purpose this actually serves me. But. It's just a good excuse to pull out the soldiers again. We'll raise all of our armies. What? Wait, who is this now? It's a defending one? Alanian Conquest. Chiefdom of Alania. Oh, okay. Yes. So now I've gotten myself caught up in two wars. That is excellent. Wars, I think, are also the only thing that get me to really, like, keep moving time forward, because otherwise I just have this habit of, like, I'm going to, like, pause, and I'm just gonna, like, take a look at every single possible thing I could do, and, like, try to learn who every single person on the map is, whereas this is a lot more beneficial. So let's go waltzing in over here. Is that an enemy? No. So I think let's do this, and we'll wrap it up. So while my armies are marching over, we'll check chat for a little bit, see what's going on. If there are people some seceding from... I don't think there's anyone seceding from Byzantium. Are there? People are saying bottom left. I hope not. Are these guys seceding? Nonsense. That'd be amazing if there was just a revolt going on in my empire that I just never actually noticed. But I think that would alert me with, like, a war thing. Surely. Surely. Wow, Georgia got half their land occupied immediately by a tiny army. Oh, okay, what are we doing? My wife, she's overjoyed. However, she's been acting strange. Let's see. Could the child belong to someone else? Possible outcome. 93% discover the truth, or 6% she loses opinion of me. Well, sure. What's the worst that could happen? Okay, so we're trying to get over here. I think that's who these guys are. So if we just go in there and occupy them, that'd be great. Of course, I trusted you all along. I found no indication she's... 6% chance she found out, and she did. Or I guess the agent stayed secret, but she... The same effect either way. Nice. Georgia's taking care of the battle for me. I am apparently laying siege. I hope I get something out of this. I hope. What I really hope for, I want to spend my time up here, because I believe they are the other enemy. And potentially, because this is a defensive war, it would be nice if I could just, like, claim some of that land. Just as a nice little bonus. I need Jeopardy music while we wait. Okay, so this army is going to need to be split up. Send one group over. Oh man, this really can't support anybody. Thought for sure I'd be able to get a little more. And this is impassable terrain, right? So what are we supposed to do to get around this? I just follow the coast, I suppose. Because that's definitely impassable terrain. I need to make sure. So, okay, so we could sneak around this way, or we can go straight along the coast, which seems to be the better option. We want to take these, probably split them both in half again, and then take each of them sort of individually and send them. Oh man, that's still too many people. Okay, well, I can send one group over here, for sure. And then I can send one group. Only 1,000. I'll send just another group of 2,000 over here. And I think it just sent the entire army over that way. Yeah. So let's take this army and send them where we were originally going to go, which was over here. So now there should be two groups. And the rest, I suppose, like, they're going to be going over there, and we can just split them once they're there. Let's take one of these groups, though, and let's hold on to them. Let's take the smaller group, and let's send them over here to... Oh, no, I don't want the whole 8,000. Let's send this group over here just to take care of some things and get us some victory points. Oh, nice. Okay, so I like that when you zoom out on the map, it shows you like who you're at war with a little fire behind them. My vassal has... Okay, so this last time, I lost a level of devotion, which was not good for me. So, I think I'm going to have to, like, just punish this person and lose some opinion. Celtics don't attack until at least 1073. Still keeping my eye on them. Also, our soldiers don't seem to be... because I think this little icon is, like, how high quality they are. Hold on. My wife is once again absent from our chambers. I confront her. Starts to find secrets. No immediate effects. We don't have anyone else finding secrets, right? Yeah, so let's just do that. Yeah, it's a lot easier in this game to keep track of your allies and your enemies. Oh, I thought I might be doing a siege here. I guess not. Let's go to a different barony and hope for the best. Maybe I can lay siege over there. In any case, we've won a battle. That'll give us a little bit of a few points. Where is Abkhazia? Okay, so this is Abkhazia. So this is where they are interested in fighting. So I can right-click to dismiss these. So that's also... I probably should have sent more of my troops through that way. How big is this battle? Okay. Not huge. We've still got the upper hand. Our guy wounded one of theirs. Excellent. I'm not sure how to make my, does anyone know how to, make, the soldiers higher quality? Someone said History House. Is History House here? Oh, he is! It's a weird episode of Life and Times. Yeah, new art style. New, narration style as well. You know, YouTube likes those, super long videos, so I've, just decided to, create a 3D graphic from the ground up, run it for a few hours. When you said Abkhazia, I thought you were gonna say Epcot. Just the sound of the word or something. Get rid of Empress, new marriage. I want to get rid of Empress, but I don't think I can divorce her. If you want to divorce her, just accuse her of adultery, then execute her. Let's see if I can do that, because I wanted to divorce her a while ago, but I couldn't because of the Pope. Does that mean I might be able to do that now? I can try to seduce her. Request divorce requires that, which I don't have. But, so it sounds like if I say... Oh, okay. So if I attempt to imprison her, which will 100% succeed, then, I mean, does that count as divorce? I don't have any hooks. It's going to be... Okay, all of my subjects are going to lose 5 opinion. How do I accuse her of... Yeah, help me out here. how do I accuse her so that I can divorce her and potentially have her executed? It's what you do when a relationship doesn't work out. If you're playing EU4, I would tell you how to... Ah, shoot. Demand conversion. Which? I guess I could just start a... If you get another cheating event arrester. Okay, I mean, I guess... I didn't realize that imprisoning her was an option in those cases. I could scheme to murder her. I'll demand conversion first, hoping that she won't do it. Terrified of me. Excellent. And hope she doesn't ask for something in return. Let's demand conversion, and then if she becomes, you know, problematic, that'll give us an excuse to get rid of her. And already we have... Oh, we captured the enemy war leader of Elania. That was super easy. So if we enforce demands, do we get anything? King Bagrat keeps... Oh, no, because this was a defensive war. What? He will not accept. But it said our war score was 100... What? What? Our war score can't go any higher. I'm a little confused. Oh, maybe I'm just not the one... Yeah, only the main participants may offer peace. That's it. That makes sense. I'm in the religion view. That's why it looked like it was all my territory. Cool. So... Aha. Okay. So am I able to occupy some land here? And if I do, am I able to keep it? Because I guess I would really want this spot on the coast more than anything. Oh no, okay, so we've already declared peace with them. We won the war led by Bagrat of Georgia against High Chieftain blah 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 Valania. So everything returns to the same before. We get money to King Bagrat, okay. Your war contribution score is 100%. Okay, so basically Georgia loves me now, and I also get some prestige. Not bad. Not bad. So all these guys, I guess, need to turn around, and march back over here. It's a shame. I really would have liked to get a little bit of coastline. We beat them too hard. We should have, made it slower. Another sun. Sure. Sounds good, Demetrios. I like that it gives you the option, like, instead of just, like, here's the name, or rename it, it gives you a couple options of, like, yes, this will be, like, the ancestor son, this will be the whatever. Who are the Seljuks fighting? I mean, that's probably not a good thing for us, because they're going to pretty easily beat these guys, I assume. And I can't join them... because they don't like me enough. They're not an ally. Plus, I've still got the truce with the Seljuks. That's trouble. I would not like for the Seljuks to get a border with Georgia. That would be a little bad. I'm still at war with these people. Oh, this is... Okay. They're still besieging. Let's go into Tbilisi. I don't totally know how territorial claims work. I guess if I don't have a claim on it, then I don't really get it. I don't think I can just, like, occupy it in a war and it's mine forever. But if there is any way to get a hold of some of these places, then it would be nice to control the area, you know, and block off the Seljuks. Espionage lovers. Aha! Aha! Okay, so here's the way that I can... Yeah. The outrage. So now, surely now that I have found evidence, I can imprison her without tyranny. Why is that not... What? So I have like definitively found out. It only gave me one option. But surely that means... Oh, okay. So if I use a secret, okay, maybe if I get the hook and then I can imprison her with that. So if I blackmail her that way and then try to imprison her, we'll see. We'll see. Perhaps I will never know reasons. Okay, so I can say I can expose it and get a rivalry. I can say it's more likely to fear the consequences. Possible outcomes: she gives in and they stop. She refuses and they all lose that, and I imprison her, and that counts as tyranny still. So it seems like no matter what I do, I can't blackmail her if I do this. If I say I need time to think, then maybe that gives me the option to, like, here, let me see if I can imprison, use a hook. Oh, all that does is it gives me more dread, but it still counts as tyranny. Well, I guess I just gotta do what I gotta do. I'll do it this way. And then I'll click that, because I already imprisoned her. Justice! Excellent. So now can I get a divorce? Or do I have to execute her? Still can't. The Pope's opinion of her has only gone up. So, let's see. What are my options? I don't think blinding her... Yeah, it's really going to be execution, but that is going to be... Oh, okay. It only loses me two opinion from everyone. And it gains me a whole bunch of prestige. And it allows me to do that. Okay. Okay, so she's burning at the stake. That it was the only option. There was no possible way to execute her otherwise. No sort of sneaky throw her in the darkest dungeon. It's just the only thing we could do was to very publicly burn her at the stake. So now we can try to get a new spouse, and maybe this will open up some opportunities if there are any. I'm still looking at Hungary and Croatia as potential sources of spouses. You know, maybe this will allow us to get closer to someone who's more useful to us. Because I tell you what, that was a really sort of disappointing fact that it was just one of my vassals. And it looks like all of these people only have first names as well. Oh, okay, here's some more. Okay, they're from further away. I think what I've got to do is I've just got to start digging into family trees. So if I go into, like, here, and I see, let's see, what relations does he have? As a princess who is married, and a prince who isn't married, has a one-year-old daughter. I could betroth one of my sons to her potentially. The queen mother of Hungary is unmarried. I could become the king of Hungary's father-in-law. That would be, I don't know what actual influence that would give me, but I do sort of love that idea. The heir to Croatia, Dalmatia. Okay, so Princess of Croatia is betrothed. Where were these people earlier when I was trying to arrange marriages? No one in his court is available for marriage. What does that... What? Nonsense. Okay. Why don't we... Is it better to marry one of my children to a prince or a princess? Because I don't know... I don't know the exact ramifications of that. If the Georgians refuse to convert to Catholicism, exterminate. Oh, that's true. The Georgians love me now. I could probably get away with converting them. That would be good. Now marry an HRE princess. Oh, duh, of course. An HRE princess would be good. That'd be excellent. Okay, so Heinrich here has no children. He has a queen of Hungary is one of his siblings. A princess who is unmarried. Okay, here's a princess who is unmarried. An evil zealot. Oh no, she's married. She's married. This princess is unmarried. I don't know what the claims are. She seems like she might have a better claim. Like, I don't know who is the better... Or I guess it depends who's older. If it really comes down to it. She's a little older, even though she's evil. Although she doesn't seem to have... Oh, no, she's dead. That's why. That's why there's no opinion of me. There are many things you can do in this game. I don't think marrying a corpse is one of them. Or at least that won't give you any claims. So, no one in her court is available for marriage. Let's see. So if I'm trying to marry one of the princesses, I could offer myself no valid characters found. Shame. I don't understand why she isn't a valid character. And I don't seem to be able to start with someone on his side either. I don't totally understand. The 1-year-old daughter of the King of Hungary is a legitimate marriage to this 65-year-old Roman emperor. Somehow I don't think they will accept this. Oh my god, they will. Does this give me any claim? Like, will I does the King of Hungary have any sons or something? I mean, I'll get 300 prestige. She'll get 200. Oh. This might just be... I mean, I'll see what Slovakia has... Or Slovakia, Croatia has to offer. But, or is it better to betroth her to one of my children? So that way I don't have issues with, like, inheritance and stepchildren. Oh, there's another... Okay. Well, I think also they might only accept if it's me personally. Oh, they won't accept it. Okay. She's... Okay. She's dear to him. I don't have a hook that I can use. That would be nice. So... Okay, so... King of Hungary... He has one child right now, which I believe, depending on how their inheritance rules mean... No, okay, she is his primary heir. Is it better for me to marry her to the current emperor? Or is it better to betroth her to one of my children? I await your feedback. Son, children. Okay. Yeah. All right. Fair. Cool. Let's do that then. So, let's marry her to my current heir. If we can. Who is... I suppose Andronikos is my heir, right? I'm gonna need to double check this, because it's gonna be real awkward if I marry her to the wrong person. No, my primary heir is Michael. Oh, he's already married. Okay. This makes things complicated, because if he is already married, that means it would be, like, my... Once I become, like, the heir, that would mean it was one of, like, my brothers or something is going to have, control Hungary, and potentially, and also have a claim to the Byzantine Empire. And that sounds like a whole mess of trouble. Is there any way I could... Does he have children already? Yeah, he does. Is there any way I could potentially kill her? Because if I kill... Oh, Princess Martha of Georgia. Great. should have thought this one through a little more. Because if I get found out there, that's going to be real bad for me. Well, I mean, it starts a war with George. No, I still wouldn't have any claims. If I were to kill her, though, if I got away with it, then I could potentially, like, unite Hungary and the Byzantine Empire so long as I make sure that the Hungarian king doesn't have any sons, which would mean I would probably need to start scheming to kill him too. And I don't know how good of a schemer I am. Like, if I attempt to murder her, 30% chance it's successful, but there's only a 45% chance that it's kept secret. So, is it better to... No, I don't think I can marry the Hungarian princess to a different one of my sons. I think it's gotta be my heir. Oh, someone's saying grandson. That's true. That's true. That's a possibility. You'll marry your daughter and say... When will you marry your daughter and sacrifice your son / grandson to the Satan? Ah, the Satan. Yep. Then jump your son on the inheritance. Yep, you are correct. You are correct. I completely forgot this was a person. My tiny... tiny 1-year-old grandson absolutely detests me. We'll see if I can make arrange a marriage. There's where all the incestual options happen. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to get my grandson on one side. I have to find him somewhere. Do I not have the option to? Why do I not seem to have the option to marry my grandson to this Hungarian princess? This is troubling. Yeah, none of these say grandson. Suppose I were to go straight to my grandson, click here, arrange marriage, and then... No, because that doesn't... Okay, wait. No, that's change character. Because that still puts it on who I have access to. I don't think I can arrange this marriage. I think I would have to wait until my character died. What I could do... Okay, here's what I think I'll do. I think my character is able to be betrothed to the Hungarian princess. By the time she becomes an adult, like, my character is going to be dead. And so, by that point, I will be able to marry her to my grandson. Because at that point, I will be the other person, he will be my son. So, what we're going to do is we're going to arrange this marriage. They will accept just barely, and I think part of that is just because of, like, me personally. So I don't think she would have accepted my grandson anyway. We're going to send this proposal. And then we're going to see how that goes. And then potentially, you know, we could kill the king of Hungary. And she would inherit everything. And there we go. The emperor of Rome is now betrothed to a one-year-old daughter. And, well, this is only terribly problematic. Let's see. Okay, so we got a few sieges going on here. There's a battle that we're not part of. These guys are still going over there. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. So soon enough, we can start to win this back. Seeing the Seljuks here does not make me feel comfortable. I don't know how they have a claim on everything. We've won another battle. Excellent. I think that was the Georgians that did that. These guys have won the siege. Are they still... Nope, they're still well supplied. They're still doing all right. These guys are good. This isn't occupied anymore. All right. I guess let's just keep marching through. Now occupy Tbilisi. It's a shame this isn't part of it, but oh well. This is so much easier than fighting the Seljuks. You take over like two places and instantly you're poised to win. I don't think any of these places can support this full army, so let's take just one of them. Oh no, but there's already people there. Where can I possibly go? Let's just send them over to the opposite side. That way the people here can actually start to recharge. These are more Georgians. There's also Seljuks here. Despite our best efforts, my agents have yet to uncover any secrets that... Oh, you mean the person that was assassinated? Yeah, she probably doesn't have any secrets anymore. Yeah. I would not be so certain. Keep it up. So now we have our spy master back, and we can continue to do some more schemes elsewhere. Although I suppose that was only looking at schemes directed against us. Oh well. The Seljuks are doing well. These guys, I believe, are now... Yep. Being well supplied. This siege should go our way. I can't seem to siege this place. Maybe I can go in and help the Georgians here. Aha! Okay. Queen Martha gains the contested county. Gets my... Oh, okay. Interesting. Okay. So Georgia has just become a little more powerful. Our war contribution was 100. Our prestige has... Yep. We are now quite distinguished. Excellent. We've gained a level of fame. Our armies can go home. I'm really not liking the look of this. Not much we can do about it. I guess... Now I feel like just waiting until, you know, we can inherit Hungary. Can, ooh, I wonder if we kill him now, though. Like, I want to kill him before he has any other children, but I'm a little anxious that that would end up calling off the marriage. Oh, he's fighting France. Interesting. Interesting, interesting. What are the odds of, okay. 20% chance of, oh no, 20% based secrecy. Yeah, so that's not, yeah, chances are that will fail entirely. So, I think if we send our spy master in to try to like get some allies in there, then that will help us out. Support schemes, find secrets. Let's have him find secrets now. Oh, I see. I can find secrets in other places? Interesting. Anyway, let's put him there. He's still pacifying people. I'm gonna have a decent claim on Hungary eventually. How do I? Because I don't. I thought there was a way that I could just use the spy master to win support over people in Hungary and try to like make them more likely to depose the king. But that does not seem to be the case. This guy actually might accept an alliance from me now. Or maybe not. I thought after the betrothal that might be an option, but it does not seem to be. My guess is that it needs to be a marriage. I guess we can attempt to sleep with him. Offer ward, making him or someone in his court the guardian, offer guardianship. Offer him a guardian, making someone in his court the ward of the chosen adult. Making him or someone else the guardian of the chosen child. Oh, wait, no, that's not exactly what I want. Are we swaying anyone still? Are we still working on. Still work. Okay, we're still working on this guy. We'll try to get hungry next. I'm gonna need some opinions. Do we, Yeah, I'm trying. That's what I was trying to do, is be guardian of my wife. Make the 1-year-old the guardian of your ward. I'm trying to figure out when. How do I boost my odds of success? In assassinating the King of Hungary. Because right now, the odds are not looking in my favor. Real quick, I will try to see. Offer King Solomon. How does this work exactly? Guardian, recipient. Okay, so guardian. Maybe that would be me. Sure. Will not accept. Base reluctance. Sending child to foreign court. Yeah. Oh, are we allied? I guess. Automatically? That's nice. Cool. So he's not gonna be super excited about that. Understandable. Understandable. We'll let time roll on. Georgia. Oh, let's see if we can get Georgia to convert real quick. Who is so their heir? Okay. Oh, so basically, once it gets to my grandson, I mean, he'll inherit Georgia either way. It would be nice if Georgia could convert, but I think that's really going to hurt our opinion. We'll see. Diplomacy. No. Hold on. Figure this out. Offer vassalage. She is de jure my vassal. Where do I need to go into the religion tab again or something? Oh, she is Catholic. I didn't realize she was Catholic already. Well, that's handy. So it's just the it's that it's Orthodox but still ruled by a Catholic. Okay. I'm cool with leaving Georgia as it is, honestly. Like, we're going to get most of the Caucasus that way. Hopefully that'll be a northern cap on Seljuk expansion. We'll find out. I don't know what's going on with this duchy. So I guess now it's just a matter of, like, waiting for time to pass and, I still don't know how to... I still feel like I need to kill Georgia. Befriend traitors within Hungary with a high intrigue skill. Yeah. I feel like I don't know why I would need to conquer Georgia. Like, Georgia is mostly... or at least the ruler is converted. I'm going to inherit it eventually. I'm more concerned with, like, making sure I have a strong claim on Hungary. And I guess the question is, I really just need to go digging around to try to find which one of the Hungarian vassals, you know, likes him the least. But they all seem to have some pretty positive opinions of him. Okay, here's a powerful vassal that doesn't. But he also doesn't like me. So this would be, again, something that I would need to try to sway. How much of a gift would I need? Oh, 300. No, thank you. No, thank you. Yeah, that's more swaying, which means I just need to pass more time. Because I want to finish the swaying that I'm already doing within my own empire. Trying not to have the Catholics and Orthodoxes killing each other. And then as soon as that's... Oh, we're losing gold. Oh, my armies are still raised. Funny how that happens. Yeah, let's disband. Yes. Yes, disband. That's the thing with this. There's never a really a good stopping point with this game. Because I'm like, oh, I'll just fight the war in Georgia. But now I've got my claws in Hungary, and I'm trying to convert Georgia. And all of a sudden, it's like, oh, but, you know, I could stay for just a little bit longer. Progress still going on that. Is my steward doing anything? I guess just go collect taxes. Nothing better for her to do. Was looking for secrets. 53 days left. Our marshal doesn't like us. That's not a good thing. Why doesn't he like us? He doesn't like us because I unlawfully executed his family. Well, not much I can do about that, unfortunately. I can put him in a dangerous situation doing some of this stuff. How do I see my control over my empire? Okay, well, he's still doing that. He's still working on domestic affairs. Not much I can do with my council. Well, you know, we still have Anatolia. So all in all, heresy. Uh-oh. The Duke of Champagne. Okay. Right. Oh, is the Duchy of Champagne You convert to Catholicism. Oh, dear. No, I don't think I can go that far. Catharism appears. Okay, God. Where are the Cathars? Duchy of Champagne. I mean, that sounds like I thought that was in France, but yeah. Is there a Champagne in? Have I read it wrong? I don't totally understand. I guess if they're not a problem for us yet, then we can just keep doing what we're doing, I guess. Oh, do we have? I see we only have part of Crimea, but that is a duchy. Do we have a claim on Crimea? Oh, it would mean war against Cumania, which wouldn't be great. I'm hoping that they're totally disorganized and doing their own things elsewhere. Raiding Alania. Oh, great. I don't think I want a war with them right now over one county. Tempting though it is. How many soldiers do they have? Their military strength. Oh, their total military strength is 3,000. I mean, if we all send our troops here, then that's going to be 3,000 against all of ours, which will probably weaken us against the Turks. But one day we shall have Crimea. Oh, yeah, so the Prince of France is converting to Catharism. That's going to be a real issue. We'll see if the Pope calls on us for help. That'd be interesting. Make some new friends that way. What is going on here? Is there still more? I see. Don't suppose I can offer to join any of his wars, huh? Oh, you know what? I might be able to join some wars in Hungary if I felt like it. I say after just saying, oh, I don't want to weaken myself for the Seljuks. But it's only. He does not lead aside an independence war. He does not lead. Shoot. And I can't. Okay, so I can't offer to join for him. And I can't offer to join for the Holy Roman Empire because they're not an ally of mine. So that's a shame. I'm just waiting for everything to suddenly be on fire. Oh, greetings, my serene liege. Despite our best efforts, my agents have yet to uncover any secrets here in court. However, I still believe there is something going on in the shadows. I only need a little more time. If there is anything, we shall find it. Send him back there. What's this? Oh, I can increase my game speed to fast. Ha ha! Though I have surely seen many battlefields before I meet my maker, my library holds tales of a war from 100 lifetimes. Acquired a great tome on the great siege of Constantinople. I wonder which one. There have been like 1,000. So I can either read from the newer tome and I gain studied an old battle, or there's a 50% chance I gain a bunch of lifestyle, martial lifestyle experience, or not. You know what? I'll take the odds. We'll see how that goes. Push forward. 80%. That's pretty good, right? Battle of Red Cliffs. Oh, interesting. So this is apparently I'm translating from Chinese. So this is for anyone that doesn't know this context. So the Battle of Red Cliffs is a famous battle from I believe after the fall of the Han Dynasty, the Three Kingdoms period. So this is a description here. Cao Cao, being one of the warlords, chained his ships from stern to stern in combat to combat seasickness. A commander of the opposing Sun Liu forces, Huang Gai, saw his chance and sent a feigned letter of surrender. Then he prepared a squadron of ships, filling them with kindling and oils, and let the wind carry them forward toward Cao Cao. As the crewless ships approached the enemy's fleet, they were set ablaze, resulting in the fiery deaths of countless men. Interesting. I thought that was Cao Cao on the offensive, because I've always heard stories of Cao Cao being the one who's like super clever and knows all the things. So I either studied the Battle of Red Cliffs for 20 years, and I can't see what that does, or I get studying ancient texts for 20 years. I think this is going to be more useful to me. And 100 martial experience. That's nice. While his numerous attempts to curry my favor have not gone unnoticed, I cannot but feel irritated by Duke Michael's sudden interest in me. And I cannot shake the feeling that the man's intentions are not pure. But he still has a secret charm. A certain charm. So he gets a closer friendship, or he loses 5 opinion, or he loses 20 opinion. I mean, I don't see any issues with boosting his opinion of me for now. We can use the help we can get. We'll see how this ends up. Oh, the Seljuks. Oh, they jumped right over. Are they at war with Kumania? If they are. No, I guess not. Okay. They're at war with whoever was over there. I'm really hoping they'll just go to war with another major power. Give me the excuse that I need. I'm going to check comments again. Cathar's Delenda Est. Three Kingdoms period. Some really important military tome traveling the Silk Road until it reaches the Byzantine Emperor a couple hundred years later. Interesting. The comments seem to be way behind where I am, but this is kind of cool. Allows me to catch up. France is going Cathar. I mean, basically, what I think is going to happen is that if I can get in with the Holy Roman Empire, and the Holy Roman Empire are already in with Hungary and Croatia. I don't know why I keep wanting to call them Slovenia. I think it's going to turn into, like, France versus the rest of Europe. And I'm okay with that if it gives me an advantage. I can ransom some more people? I see. Oh, she must have been the one that, like, cheated or whatever, and we locked her up so we wouldn't lose piety. We're still losing piety. It's going to be a while before we get back to being dutiful. That's a shame. One day. That's the thing I did not take into account while converting to Catholicism. Occupant, yeah. I guess I'm content to let my vassals fight each other, because I'm not... I mean, I'm sure one of them is going to, you know, surprise warring states take over the whole empire without me even noticing, but I can accept that. Oh, are we still... Yeah, there's... I'm sure we've already gone through this once. I want to sway... I think I want to sway the Holy Roman Emperor. Because I could work on Hungary. Or no, I guess what I want to do is I want to sway some of Hungary's vassals. So that way they're more... amenable to plots against him. This guy's realm size is 2, but he has the least. He doesn't hate me. He already. Oh no, it's plus 19 for the liege. Powerful vassal, powerful vassal. Let's start with this guy. Let's see where they all are. Let's start here. He seems to be one of the most powerful, and he already doesn't like his liege that much. So we'll start there. and we will try to sway him.